I wonder if Barack Obama really in his heart believes that Israel has a right to exist. I wonder, in his heart, right? For real, if he's gonna go here at this time, you have to wonder.
That's right, in the midst of Biden's full support for Netanyahu's war on Gaza, a lot of people are looking for voices of reason. And one of those voices might be the former president of the United States, Barack Obama, who put out a statement on social media and on his Medium post. Yes, people are still using that. Obama is there. And it was actually pretty interesting. There was a lot of support for the current president. There was no disagreement with Biden's strategy, but there were a few choice paragraphs that you, as you see there, Mark Kelly from Newsmax had some issues with. But let's look at what Obama said. He said, America itself has at times fallen short of our higher values when we engaged in war. And in the aftermath of 9/11, the US government wasn't interested in heeding the advice of even our allies when it came to the steps we took to protect ourselves against Al-Qaeda. An admission. This was obviously under George W. Bush, but an admission that the steps we took actually set us back when it came to peace in the region. And then he writes, the Israeli government's decision to cut off food, water, and electricity to a captive civilian population threatens not only to worsen a growing humanitarian crisis, it could further harden Palestinian attitudes for generations, erode global support for Israel, play into the hands of Israel's enemies, and undermine long-term efforts to achieve peace and stability in the region. Wow. That is going farther than President Biden has gone, who has not said anything about the cutting off of food, water, and electricity. Finally, and this is what Kelly had the biggest issue with, he said it means acknowledging that Palestinians have also lived in disputed territories for generations. Many of them were not only displaced when Israel was formed, but continue to be forcibly displaced by a settler movement that too often has received tacit or explicit support from the Israeli government. The Palestinian leaders who've been willing to make concessions for a two-state solution have too often had little to show for their efforts, and that it is possible for people of goodwill to champion Palestinian rights and oppose certain Israeli government policies in the West Bank and Gaza without being anti-Semitic. And that set Kelly off. Here's what he said.
This is incredibly inaccurate, basically a lie. This is straight out of the anti-Semitic playbook and worldview. And incredibly insensitive at this moment with what Israel is going through. And the Palestinians were offered a state in 1948. They rejected it and all of the Arab world. And since then, there have been three wars to eradicate Israel.
I'm just pulling things out of my butt. They were offered a state. Anyway, in case you didn't see the writing on the wall when it comes to Barack Obama and where his true allegiances lie, Kelly just had to sort of, you know, drive that one home for his audience at Newsmax.
He is, after all, Barack Obama. Make that Barack Hussein Obama. Under ordinary circumstances, his middle name has nothing to do with anything. But I think we all see where his allegiance lies. It's certainly not with America right now and not with our strongest ally.
He's a secret Muslim. His name is Barack Hussein Obama. Cenk, time is a flat circle. We are back to calling Barack Obama a terrorist. Thoughts?
Yeah, so look, Barack Obama barely ever gets out of his compound to say anything, to help, etc. So that seems like a funny way to start a compliment for him. But but I'm being serious. I really appreciate that he came out and said this, because he doesn't do it very often, and it's a powerful statement. It's obviously 100% accurate. And very sensible. He's not, you know, it's classic Obama. He's not going 5% out of bounds in any direction, but at least he's being human and decent and calling for, you know, acknowledging the humanity of Palestinians, and cutting off water, electricity, power is despicable. And he doesn't say despicable, but at least he calls it out. So I appreciate President Obama doing this. And so since he had a human moment there and was really quite great about it, obviously conservatives are gonna hate it. And they're gonna call him, they're implying that he's Muslim. Which too, some Muslims are now, I mean, Franny and Rayvana covered it earlier in the show, are considering voting against Biden because they're frustrated by his policies. But then that would mean that they might vote for Trump. Trump again doubled down and said that he might ban all Muslims from the country. So, and for Republicans, they think it's normal to use Muslim as an insult. Mm-hmm. Like Barack Hussein Obama. Okay, even if that were like he's not Muslim, he just happens to have that middle name that his dad gave him because his dad grew up in Kenya. But let's say that he was Muslim. Why is that an insult? But for exactly. every Republican, they think, got him. He's guilty of being Muslim. Well, you just told us that you're a bigot and a racist. It's okay, but don't catch feelings then. Like when you say Muslim is terrible by definition, and then we say, well, that's what a bigot would say. Then they start crying. Like, I got called a bigot when I was just hating other human beings like Muslims and labeling them all the same thing because I despise them. But I got called a bigot. So Greg yeah. Kelly, you know, him being a bigot.
Greg Kelly. I said, called him Mark.
Did I? No,
I called him Mark. Oh, no, you called I don't him Mark. Know. Okay. Mark, Greg, whatever.
Yeah. So Greg Kelly being a bigot, being anti-Muslim, lying about what the situation there is Tuesday. It's the most normal thing in the world. That's what these hateful zealots on the right wing do. But the last part of it is the questioning the allegiance. Brother, that was a two-term United States president, okay? And then whenever anybody says something about Trump on the left, they're like, he was a president, American president. How about Barack Obama? He's two-term president. Unlike your bitch loser Donald Trump, who couldn't get a second term and then cried about it for the rest of his life. Okay, so you know who I question? Like, we're questioning allegiance now. Like Greg Kelly's making it seem like Israel is America. I'm sorry, brother, but Israel is a different country. They're an ally and they were attacked viciously, and I support them on that. I don't support them on the death and destruction that they're visiting upon Gaza now, but you're making it sound like they're the 51st state. So what's your allegiance, mm-hmm. Greg Kelly? You sound like a traitor to me.
100%. Last thing I'm going to say is that I think it's important to remember that of all the presidents we've had, specifically Democratic presidents, of course, Obama actually put a little bit of daylight between US foreign policy and Israeli policy, right? He wanted a freeze on settlements. Netanyahu was furious with him. He did the Iran deal. Netanyahu was furious. And Republican Congress people invited Netanyahu to speak in front of them. Remember that? They wrote a letter to Iran that was like, JK, we don't want the Iran deal. Ew, we have a black president. Do you remember that? He might be Muslim. Like straight up. And so here's my thing about Biden. He's gone in the opposite direction. The legacy was Obama's foreign policy, bro. And instead, you doubled down on Trump's foreign policy when it comes to Israel-Palestine. You're such a disappointment on this issue. You're such a disappointment on foreign policy, specifically on Israel.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.